Okay, Tom, I'm not going to wait until some example media comes in, but I'm grabbing some media to be similar to what you have. It is not quite ready to arrive, but I want to go over some things first, and hopefully by the time I'm done talking your ear off, I'll have an example to use. So, just because the group is anti-piracy doesn't mean a lot of us who are in it aren't. And I have to be very careful as the resident group expert to dissuade any piracy talk. But lots of us get our media from the same place. So here's some media that's come in that I haven't prepped yet. So what I'm going to do first is go to the Plexus name and guide for TV shows. And I don't know if I have
You
it.
have an informational
Got it
message.
for movies, but not for TV shows saved. No, that's not it. All right, let me grab it. I'm kind of unprepared here. Here we are. So basically, Plex is going to pull content from either TMDB or TVDB. Hold on a second. Just the usual, please, if you don't mind, bud. Okay, thanks. So Plex keeps a combined cached database themselves of the database from both TMDB and TVDB for their TV show libraries, which is why you can kind of name things to either library. Let me see where I'm looking. So you can include the TVDB database number into this proper show name and even the episode name if you want, or the TMDB.
You
So
have
I'm
an
going to show you
informational
what I do
message.
with FileBot, but basically, if I go to TV database, which is what I use for a Plex library, it's easier to work out of than it is the TMDB for TV shows. So what am I bringing in here? All right, I'm about a minute away from having one season of Friends, and then 2 minutes away from having another season. So if we go in here to Friends, and go to season. Well, this is how this show should be named. That's the most basic show folder name. And then you just take your season name from here, but it should be 01, season 01, season 02, and so forth. Then the episode name would be Friends, space dash space, S01EO1, space dash space, optional. Episode name dot mkv or dot mp4. It's pretty simple. Let's go to TMDB. And again, remember, Plex keeps a combined cache. So the only difference is TMDB puts the year in. And that's not a bad idea to put that in by default. But with most shows, you don't need the year. Why this is kind of a pain in the ass is, where do you go for season? Click on season 10 and do this. Click there. It's hard to find the season list, and it's just easier to work out of the TV on DB instead of this. But you can get the year from TMDB. So I've got my first episode of Friends in. So let me go to my folder. All right, so I'm going to cut that out. And I'm going to go to a temporary directory that I use for FileBot. Let me stop that so I don't get any seating errors. I can remove that. And let's see what we got here. We've got this stupid folder. It's got all our episodes in it, but it's pretty stupid. It won't work for Plex. And this also has all the subtitles zipped up. I'm not going to get too much into subtitles, but I can use FileBot to prep this quickly. So let's do this. Let's copy it. Let's put an extra copy right there. So I'm going to right click on this. Let me do this. Now I've got two seasons. And let me copy that there too, and then go stop it so I don't keep getting errors. Okay, so while that's copying, let's go back into this folder. And I'm going to just highlight both of them and right click and open them in FileBot. Now, I've got custom expressions in here that I'm going to use, but without using them, you can simply go to Match and choose Episode Mode, the TVDB. We're going to make sure we choose Friends, the correct one from that list. Now we got a problem here. Let's edit the format. Well, that should be correct. I don't know why it was listed, but it didn't come up correctly. So this is going to rename everything just like this. It's going to give us an error on the subtitles because for each episode I have both a default and a regular subtitle. So if I just click rename, let me do season 7. Alone. Match, TVDB, Friends, Select. So if I just hit rename, I'm going to get this conflict because there's an extra sub for each episode. I'm going to hit skip, and let me just move that down. And now if I go in here, these are all named properly, including the subs that are buried in here. I'd have to move those subs manually if I wanted. But you can simply rename this as season space 07, and you've quickly prepped those files for Plex to find them. So let me show you a little upgrade. I'm going to open both of them up in FileBot, and I'm going to use my custom expression. And let me edit the preset. So this is my custom expression. This sets up the folder structure too. Name of the series, I add the year, sets the season number up. It adds information about the video format and the audio format and the codecs. And it also looks to discover if there's any embedded English subs, and if it finds embedded subs that aren't English, it assigns an unknown moniker to them, UND sub. If they are embedded English subs, it says ENGSUB. So let me get out of here and let me use that preset. All right, so we're going to use this one. It's still Friends, we'll select. And you'll see how now this has created folder structure with a year. So now I'm going to hit rename. I still have the same conflict because I have multiple subtitles for each episode, both a hearing impaired and a default one. Now I'm going to leave FileBot open. So everything's in here proper, but if we look at the first subtitle, this is 24.5 kilobytes. For season 7, those old subtitles are still here. and that's 23.8. So I know FileBot renamed the hearing impaired one as the default and left the default one alone. Well, if I really want them, I can go back and I can quickly do this little magic. I can do .sdh, copy what I did, drop down and quickly apply it to all these episodes. And let me stop there. I don't have to do all of them. Now if I come back to FileBot, because I didn't close it, I can simply hit rename, skip again, and it took those few that I had renamed properly as the hearing impaired and allowed the default one to now be moved out of the original folder. And if I go back to that original folder to subs, you'll see the first five no longer have the subtitle folder because they were moved and that original folder was deleted. So I've just quickly prepped two seasons of Friends perfectly for my Plex server. I do have to screw around with the rest of the subtitles, but I've already got this show on the server, so that doesn't really matter. So let me kill this, and let me go to the first one that was a backup. Well, not that one. This one. And I'll open that with FileBot again. I have a custom expression that simply renames the episode and adds the TMDB ID number. I don't find that's necessary to have that number, but if I've got a weird show that doesn't want to match up with Plex, I can run this on it and add that number for whatever reason. I can rename just the episodes without creating folder structure with one custom expression, and you'll see this extra information. Well, let's do it this way. Let's see, where are we? Let's go back into here. The extra information is 1080p. It's encoded with the 265 encoder. It's a 6-channel audio in the AAC codec. And of course, with subtitles, had to be manually. So this can do a lot. I'm going to send this video to you. You can't share it publicly because this is just, well, let's say you can't share it in the group, because this wouldn't be cool in the group. I could probably get away with sharing this in Plexaholics, but just keep this under your hat. I'm going to get the video prepped to YouTube and send it to you. It'll take a little while for the HD version. If you're interested in this kind of stuff, I'll send you my custom expressions, and all you have to do is install FileBot. You get a free trial, I think. I don't know how long. It's like $6 a year. Buy a license, get it going, and you don't have to worry about the default expressions. Come to this little icon here. It looks like a little piece of paper for presets. Click the presets, click Edit Preset, click New Preset, name it whatever you want. And if you're creating a TV show expression, leave it at the TVDB, paste in my custom expressions that I can send you, and hit save. And if you're going to use a movie expression, just change this down here to the movie database, not the movie database TV. Click that and paste the custom expression in. And I might as well quickly show you that. Make sure I don't get any seating errors. Hold on a minute. All right, what do I have here? I can get rid of these two TV shows. I was just looking for something to come in fast. All right, so let me move these out of here and into here. And we'll remove them from the client. Okay, so these have got subtitles too. So what I do when I have a group of movies, I select them all, open in FileBot, and the first thing I'm going to do is just rename the media where it is. You can see where I'm getting my files from. I'm going to hit rename. Then I'm going to go in to the first one and bring the subtitle over. Get rid of the extra stuff. And there might have been two subtitles, and if there were, only one would have been renamed. Then I'm going to open it up in a text editor. And I'm going to look for this information. Water splashing, girl laughing. Could be any place in the file, but now I know that's a SDH, or a hearing impaired subtitle. So I'm going to just do .sdh. When I run FileBot again, it'll capitalize it. So I'll do the same thing. Get rid of the extra. Check to see what type of subtitle it is. That looks like a default one. And oh, by the way, you could have three subtitles with a movie or a TV show. You could have the hearing impaired, which will be the largest size. The default subtitle will be slightly smaller. And if there's a forced subtitle for foreign language sections, that would be named English.forced. And you can have server settings that automatically display forced subtitles for all your media and all your users. All right, so let's move this one next to the movie. Get rid of the junk files. Check to see what type it is. So it's just a default one. So now I'm going to select them all again. Open it with FileBot. Choose this one. Now, if I'm renaming on my Synology NAS, it might put them in different spots. It might go up a directory. So I've got a couple different expressions I use, and they behave differently depending whether I'm on local storage or my NAS. And if you get all my expressions, you'll just have to figure out what it does where for you. So you'll see this creates the movie folder with the TMDB number for a can't miss match. And it also creates that TMDB number in the movie file name along with the extra information. So I'll hit rename, go back in. I've got these great folders now with the database number in it for the movie. And look at this. Now, if you have to manually get subtitles, you'd want to, let me get rid of that file, I don't need it. You'd have to check for sync by opening this movie up and skipping around into three sections, beginning, middle, and end. And if the subtitles sync in all three spots, you're golden if you're looking for a manual subtitle. I can't show that on YouTube, I'll get a copyright strike if I open that up. So, this is quick. If you're interested, after dinner tonight, I'll send you my FileBot expressions. And if you need help getting it going, let me know. I'll see if I can do that. But your naming structure, buddy, is atrocious. Just horrible. But we've all been there. Should have seen my file names when I first started out. And you just definitely can't leave the scene release names. But it's easy. So if this was the scene release for the second season of Family Ties, you'd simply name it. And you'd be done. Then you'd just have to go in and clean up the file names too, because they'd be atrocious as they were from the scene release. But FileBot makes quick work of it. So I'm not a professional YouTuber. I'm just a Plex enthusiast who wish somebody else did videos when I was starting out so that I could not have made all the boneheaded moves I made too. Anyway, happy Sunday. Enjoy the rest of your afternoon, buddy.